Would you like to bill your property management service clients in the smoothest and easiest way? Well, then you should use the technique shown in this video, billing clients for management services. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. How do we bill our clients? Well, we send them an invoice with the amount they owe us as per our agreement. The amount is usually a percent of the gross rent that we collect. You must enter an invoice for each individual tenant so that the landlord client can see exactly how much was decreased from their payout balance for each tenant's rent. The invoices can be sent individually or just summarized on a monthly statement that you send to the landlord client. Don't worry, you only have to enter the invoice one time ever, and that's what's great about QuickBooks. Once it's correct and saved once, you can memorize the invoice so it will be entered automatically by QuickBooks. That's how great this is. First example, let's imagine on January 31, the end of the very first month that we're operating, we created an invoice for $300 for January service regarding tenant Betty Boop under Alan Arby, the landlord. Now, this is what the trial balance looks like before we send an invoice to one of our landlord clients that we earned $300 from them in management fee service for one particular tenant. But if we make one invoice billing a landlord client for one particular tenant's service that they got, what will happen? Well, the $300 that we earned in service fee will show up as management fees income for the first time in the trial balance. And because we are billing the client and taking it out of what we're going to pay them, it means at the moment we bill them for the service we rendered, the amount we owe them will decrease by $300 and become $13,700 rent payable to landlord clients. Let's see if that's the result. Let's open the trial balance before we record our first invoice. To record the invoice, click Invoice. And of course, we put the last day of the month, the first month that we've rendered services for all of our landlord clients. Now, we are billing Alan Arby, but we're billing him specifically for the service that we rendered to Betty Boop as a percent of her income. And there's only one item to bill her for, property management services. And in the case of Betty, we know that if we bill 10% of the rent to the landlord, and then Betty's rent is $3,000, that means that we know with the amount is going to be $300 every single time because Betty's rent is $3,000 every single time. And when we click Save and Close, let's just stop this from popping up in the future. Here. Okay. Notice the results are exactly as what we expected. The rent payable to landlord clients decreased. We owe them less because we earned $300 in management fees income. But the most important report to check is right here. Look at this. We were going to pay $3,000 to Alan as a result of managing Betty, but because we are now billing $300, we only have to remit a $2,700 payment to Alan because of Betty, because even though we collected $3,000, we keep $300 for when we billed Alan. Let's do a second example. let's imagine on still on January 31, let's do Candy Charles. Her rent was $4,000, so the amount that we keep from her rent would be $400. So if we bill, if we send an invoice declaring that we earned income for Alan as a result of Candy Charles, we earned $400 more in income, so management fees income should increase. However, the landlord, we owe to the landlord $400 less in a remittance because we just earned service fee and we're going to take it out of what we pay back. So these should be the numbers after doing the second example. Very simple. All right, this is really annoying. Okay, very simple. We again just click invoice and leave the date, and this time we're billing Alan for Candy Charles and the service we did on her behalf and property management services. And in this case, by the way, 400. By the way, your invoice number should be invoice number 2. I was just experimenting with the file, but this should only be the second invoice in your file. 400, as you can see, is 10% of the 4,000 that we collect. So we bill for 400 in services and withhold that from the payout. So we click save and close, and the results on the trial balance are exactly as what we expected. But if you want to see the important details, look at the landlord payout balances report, and you see we were going to give Alan 4,000 because we collected that from Candy, but we are keeping 400 for the service income that we earned. So now we only owe Alan 3,600 as a result of Candy, which means we only have to pay Alan 6,300. We did collect 7,000 for Alan, but we're only going to give him 6,300 because we billed him for each individual service for each individual tenant. Now let's see how easy it is to do the other client now that we know how to do it. We're still at the end of the month, and we're going to send an invoice to Dave Deeney specifically for the tenant Eddie Edwards, $300, 10% of Eddie's rent. What will the result be if we bill for $300 more? Well, we've earned $300 more in management fees income. However, that means we have to pay out $300 less in the future because we're going to withhold what we've earned from the payout. Let's see if these are the results. Very simple. Click invoice. QuickBooks remembers we're at the end of the month. Don't do this. You messed up your number. I messed up my numbers, but yours should say the number 3. It doesn't really matter. You can change the number to anything you want, but we're billing Dave specifically for Eddie Edwards on the end of the month date, and we're billing for property management services $300. After we click save and close, we can check the trial balance. Management fees income is exactly as what we expected, and rent payable to landlord clients went down to exactly the amount we expected. But most importantly, the landlord payout balance report shows that instead of paying Dave Deeney the $3,000 we collected from Eddie, we're only going to pay $2,700 of what we collected to Eddie because we earned this $300 from the invoice. And lastly, we will bill Dave Deeney for Freddie Froda, $400, because Freddie's rent is $4,000. So if we've earned $400 more in management fees income, that goes up to $1,400, but then we will pay out $400 less later because of what we earned, so that goes down to $12,600. Let's take a look if that's the result. Very simple. Invoice, it remembers the date. All you have to do is choose Freddie Froda, choose the only item of service the company offers, and put the amount we're billing your client, specifically for that one tenant. Click save and close, and the results are exactly as what we expected. And now you can see we know exactly how much to pay each client. You see, when we give Alan his money at the end of January, we're only giving him $6,300 because he's only entitled to $2,700 from the $3,000 we collected from Betty, and he's only entitled to $3,600 from the $4,000 we collected for Candy because of the income that we earned from them on the invoice. And again, you could double click, you could email or print the invoice and you could send them in a batch, or you could basically just filter this report and send this, the that customer's piece of this report to explain everything.